And it is going to be a star-spangled celebration in Maysville coming up on Friday night.
We're joined by the Commissioner of Veterans Affairs, Heather French Henry, to tell us all about it. Welcome. Glad to have you back today.
Thank you. I'm glad I got the memo on the royal blue.
Yeah, it's the blue thing. Here we are.
Blue, so that's...
Well, that's
I'm
right.
With you. Yeah. I'm with you.
Welcome back home over here.
Thank you.
Tell us what is going to be going on with this big celebration in Maysville.
Well, annually they have this wonderful concert for the retired seniors volunteers. Program. They put this great Veterans Day celebration on, and it usually falls on a weekend. So Friday night will be their Veterans Day patriotic celebration. There'll be 2 hours chock full of wonderful guests. I'll be singing and speaking a little bit. Singing is not a natural part of my role as commissioner right now, but I still do that. So I'll be doing God Bless the USA. There'll be a wonderful local talent, the Cantrell family, just some of our star-studded talent for Maysville. And we anticipate, you know, every year between 550 and 600 people. There's free admission, so they will take donations, of course, for the RSVP program. But it should be a star-studded evening. I've done this a number of times, and for Maysville, it's quite a celebration.
I love Maysville. It's a great city. You have such a passion for Veterans Affairs. Tell us about that. Why does it mean so much to you?
Well, certainly as the daughter of a disabled Vietnam veteran, families, you have a unique perspective being the daughter and seeing from the outside in and being that caretaker of that veteran. And for every veteran in the state of Kentucky, all 340,000 plus of them, you think about the families that surround them, because whatever hits a veteran also impacts that family. And so having been impacted by my father's issues coming home from Vietnam, and then as Miss America taking that on as my platform, for the last 15 years have been working as an advocate, right? So I've been lobbying for change and lobbying for legislation, and now to be put in this role by the governor as commissioner, where you can actually sign things into action, you can implement and be the change, that is amazing. And I will say it's a breath of fresh air to be able to do that for Kentucky's veterans.
Really, and you good. Were telling us, I mean, you are very busy in this role, doing lots of things and really trying to get that message out there of how important it is that, that we respect and recognize our veterans.
That's right. We have a great sense of urgency in this nation. Not only have we signed on as a commemorative partner for the 50th anniversary for Vietnam commemoration, because it was 50 years ago, remember this year, that the Gulf of Tonkin resolution was signed. So making sure that we are properly still welcoming home our Vietnam veterans. They're our largest population of veterans to date. But now that we're seeing this downsize in our armed forces, we're starting to see a lot of young men and women who are getting discharged into civilian life. And we have to be there to help them transition into civilian life. So at the Kentucky Department of Veterans Affairs, we take veterans from the time they're discharged as early as 18 to the time they're 118. So whether it's getting benefits, whether it's long-term care, or at our cemeteries that we call our forever care, we try to take care of every need for they and their family. So it's important for communities to understand what they can do. And, you know, part of what communities can do are things like the patriotic celebrations, where you highlight veterans, you start that conversation with children about what true patriotism is and what a real hero is. You know, who, when we think about heroes today and we think about our American idols, I think all too often we think of the wrong people. And these men and women and their families truly should be at the top of the priority list for
they
our
are our heroes.
Absolutely.
And it's a star-spangled celebration November 7th in Maysville. We've had that information on the screen.
Excellent.
Thank you very much.
Good
for coming.
To see you.
It's great to see you.
Thanks
Thank
for coming.
You.